Hello and welcome to another video unboxing for the Cool Kingdom YouTube channel, and today we are bringing you the brand new Raging Tempest Yu-Gi-Oh! Booster Box. So we finally have the Zodiac support coming out in here, as well as a whole bunch of other support for things like Cardians and some new archetypes as well, so it's going to be really exciting to open this up. As per usual, you can see we've just got standard artwork on the front and sides, and some basic information about the different cards in the set, and then the silver pack. So in here we do get 24 packs. There are 9 cards in each of those packs, and we have a guaranteed super rare or higher in every single one, as per the newer Konami policy. So let's open it up. As always, this box can be turned into the store display mode by just putting up the flap so you can display your packs nicely to your customers. And we're going to go through this box one half at a time, so we'll start off with the 12 packs on this side and then we'll move over to the other side. So let's get into these packs. So we start off with the Super Soldier Synthesis, so a new ritual spell for the archetype. We have a Terminal World next. Rocket Hand, Shinobird's Calling, that's one of the new archetypes. Then we have some more Subterra support with Nemesis Defender, and a Subterra Cave Clash as our first super. It's pretty nice. Cypher Spectrum, so basically Dark Side of the Moon. Then we have an Ancient Gear Howitzer, so a lot of people psyched for the new Ancient Gear support in here, and a Mechanical Arc Fiend. So some pretty interesting stuff already. If you didn't attend a sneak peek, I definitely recommend doing some sealed pack play with this set. It's pretty interesting what you can do. Then we have a Perushadol Aeon, which is pretty interesting. Recardination, Beginning of Heaven and Earth, Ancient Gear Reborn, and then a Crystron Quarion Gandrax is the new boss monster for the Crystrons. This looks pretty interesting. So that's an ultra rare for us. A Shinobird Crane, a Zodiac Sign, a Massive Morph, and a Crystron Rion. So the Zodiac archetype is definitely one that's going to be very popular. It is essentially a Tier 0 deck in this format, or a Tier 0 engine is probably a better way of looking at it. Then we have Machine Angel Ritual, Absolute Ritual, Shinobird Crow, Cypher Atrenger, a Performer Pearl Handstand Akun, a Super Heavy Samurai Stealth Ninja, and a Spiral Gear Utility Wire as the Super. Then a Symphonic Warrior Guitar, so this is one of the new imports, which is actually very useful for some interesting Pendulum combos. Then Eater of Millions, and a Rank Up Magic Cypher Ascension. Another Perushadol Aeon, or Aeon. Lightsworn Judgment is pretty nice for the new Lightsworn support. Metronome, Spiral Tough, and a Neo Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. So this is one of the coolest looking Galaxy Eyes monsters that's ever come out, so I definitely recommend just grabbing it for the way that it looks. Super Quantal Elfin Spike, a Speedroid Gun Prize, Cypher Spectrum, and a Fairy Tail Rella, which I believe is a short print for the set. So Fairy Tail cards are a pretty cool archetype. I believe they're all level 4 light spellcasters, and they've got some cool effects. So here we have a White Princess, a Shinobird Pigeon, Perushadol Aeon, a Shinobird's Calling, we have a Switcheroo, a Switcheroo. Pretty interesting. And the secret rare, the Sea Monster of Theseus, the most powerful card in the game, according to Konami. So yeah, it's pretty interesting. It's a good instant fusion target, and it's good that in the UK print we get the word tuna, and actually fusion. So there has been some problems with this in the foreign prints, but I believe that all of the Cool Kingdom stock is English, so you'll be absolutely fine with all of that. So that's a very nice secret rare to get. Then we have a Cyber Tutubon, Eater of Millions, Shinobird Power Spot. Then an Ancient Gear Hunting Hound, which allows you to fusion summon. Machine Angel Absolute Ritual, an Apprentice Piper, Fusion Parasite, a Zodiac Rat here as our super, which is really good because you need three to play the deck. Then we have a Flower Cardian, a Cherry Blossom with Curtain, the Speedroid Gun Prize, a Zodiac Bunny Blast, which is semi-relevant for the deck, but still a nice card, and a Crystron Rion. Magispect to Gust, so additional Magispect to support it. Beginning of Heaven and Earth. Speedroid Horse Stunts. Ancient Gear Hunting Hound. A Chenoa Baroness, a Peacock. And a Super Rare Tierra, Source of Destructions. This is a pretty interesting new card. Kind of like the old Sephira. A Cyber Spectrum. Hebo, Lord of the River. And a Miscellanosaurus. So this is actually really useful for the new dinosaur support when it comes out. Then a Zodiac combo, actually relevant for the deck, so this is pretty interesting, probably a one-of if you're playing the deck. Shinobu Pigeon, a Performer Pal Handstand Akun, a Spiral Tough. Then we have a Dark Contract with the Entities as an Ultra Rare. This is a really nice support for the DDD archetype. A Simp Amplifier, a Cyber Tutubon, Eater of Millions, and a Super Quantal Alphen Strike. Then we have a Yoko Tuna, Super Soldier Synthesis, Recardination, Apprentice Piper, Fusion Parasite, a Zodiac Whiptail as our super. Again, another three off the deck. A Zodiac Bunny Blast, a Mechanical Arc Fiend, and a Shinobu Power Spot. Then a Zodiac Ram Ram. Which might not see play at first, but in the OCG they're playing it at 3, so this is, card is still definitely relevant and worth picking up. Symphonic Warrior Synthesis, Zodiac Combo, Lost Wind is our rare, and Delta the Magnet Warrior is the new Magnet Warrior support as our super, very nice to see. Miscellaneosaurus, Zodiac Sign, Shiranyu Style Samsara, and an Eater of Millions. Then another Beginning of Heaven and Earth, Magispect to Gust, Shinobird's Calling, Shinobird Crow, a Fusion Recycling Plant, I believe this is the TCG exclusive, pretty nice, and a little bit of a misprint there, so there's always additional value in misprints. And then we have a Heavy Armored Train Iron Wolf as the rank 4, that's pretty cool. And then a Shinobird Crane, Flower Cardian Cherry Blossom with Curtain, and a Zodiac Sign. Then another Performer Pal, Handstand Akun, a Yoko Tuna, White Princess, a Fusion Parasite, Subterra Cave Clash as Super again, a Symphonic Warrior Guitar, Symphonic Warrior Mics, a Crystron Rion, and an Ancient Gear Howitzer. So that's it for the first half of the box. Some pretty interesting stuff. We've had one secret. Let's see if we can get another one. And also, we're going to go through the second half a little bit faster because you've seen most of the cards in the set now. Okay, so moving on to the second half of this box. See if we can get some more interesting stuff from here. So another Absolute Ritual, Cypher Charger, Horse Stilts, Synthes, Nemesis the Defender, and another Tierra as a super, Miscellaneous Saurus, Shinobi Salvation, and Guitar. Another Ram-Ram, Recarnation, Ritual Beast Return is pretty interesting. Wind Witch Crystal Bell, so it's a cool new archetype. And a Wind Witch Ice Spell, so probably the most important of the Wind Witches. This is the girl who gets you the entire combo for a Crystal Wing, so that's pretty nice. Speedroid Gunprise, Rank Up Magic Cipher Ascension, Eater of Millions, and a Void Feast, which is very, very good in the Infernoid deck. Then Apprentice Piper, Cypher Atrasia, Nice One Judgment, Absolute Ritual, then a Shiranui Sand Saga, and a True King Lithosagim, the Disaster, is our super. Very, very interesting, and even has utility in the Dinosaur deck, so really one of my favorite new archetypes is the True King. Then we have another Cherry Blossom with Curtain, Samsara, and a Zodiac Sign. Four Stilts, Heaven and Earth, White Princess, a Spiral Mission Recapture. Then we have a Chaos Ancient Gear Giant, Shinobi Salvation, Cypher Spectrum, Speedroid Gunprize, and a Warrior Max. Then a Judgment, another Aeon, Zodiac Combo, Shinobi's Calling. It's the Ritual Spell for the deck. Then we have a Flower Guardian, a Light Flare, which is pretty interesting. A Brave Eyes, a Pendulum Dragon is our secret rare, so we got the two secret fusions from this box. Very, very cool looking card. Absolutely love the artwork on this monster. It's fantastic. Then a Super Quantal Alphen Spike, Shiranui Style Samsara, Hebo, Lord of the River. Some very cool synchro monsters, Exes monsters, and fusion monsters in this set. Really great range. Horse Stilts, Gust, another Ram-Ram, a Crystal Bell, Heavy Armored Train Iron Wolf, Guitar, Amplifier, Cyber Tutubon, and a Samsara. So we should have a few more Ultra Rares in this box. So it'll be cool to see what they are. We have another Hunting Hound, Rocket Hand, Synthesis, Ritual Beast Return. Then we have the Subterra Behemoth Volteleric, which is really, really cool looking. Then a Dragon Caller Magician as a super, a Bunny Blast, a Crane, and a Shinobird Power Spot. Then another combo, Super Soldier Synthesis, Pigeon, a White Princess, a Nemesis Defender, and a Cyber Angel Natasha. Definitely, I think, at least a two of in the deck. Is really, really good in being able to recur constantly. So you either play it, I think, at 1, 0, or 3, probably, because it's really good when it gets going. Then a Tutubon, Amplifier, and a Salvation. Pigeon, Piper, Etranger, Light Flare, a Spigale Misty. The Salt for Spiral players will be strong because of that one letter there that kind of loses the synergy with the archetype, but it's still a very, very nice card and has a good effect, so why not? Miscellaneous Saurus, another Howitzer, Ascension, and Lord of the River. Recarnation, another Calling, another Gust, another Recycling Plant, a Crystron Sylphefna, which is pretty interesting for the Crystron archetype, a Void Feast, a Rion, Howitzer, and Hebo. Hunting Hound, Shinobird Crow, Beginning of Heaven and Earth, Another Terminal World, a Zodiac Borbo. So this is the first Zodiac Exes monster that we've got, but it's very, very important to have this in the deck. Then another Rapier for the deck, which is pretty nice. A Cherry Blossom with Curtain, a Zodiac Sign, and an Ascension. And for the final pack, let's see if we can get anything higher than a Super. I don't know if we're expecting it, but let's see. So we have a Zodiac combo. Sheen Angel, Absolute Ritual, Magispectic Gust, a Wind Witch Winterbell, it's pretty nice for the Wind Witch combo, and we have a Cyber Angel Natasha, so two of the new Cyber Angel, that's really nice for the deck. Definitely worth picking up if you play Cyber Angels, a Cyber Tutubon, a Void Feast, Ancient Gear Howitzer, and the final card is a Symphonic Warrior Minx. So that's it for opening up this box. We're going to take a quick recap of some of the higher rarity cards that we managed to pull from this Raging Tempest box. It's been very interesting, and you can see the massive pile of commons and rares that we already have here. Just huge tower there, just from the single box, plus all of these rarer cards. So let's go through some of the holos here. So we got two copies of Tierra, two copies of Zodiac Rapier, one Zodiac Whip Tail, one Crystron Solfefner, one Dragon Caller Magician, one True King Lithosagim, the Disaster, one Delta the Magnet Warrior, two Subterra Cave Clash, one Spiral Gear Utility Wire, two Cyber Angel Natasha, one Chaos Ancient Gear Giant, and two Heavy Armored Train Ironwolf, and one Neo Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. So that's it for the Super Rares. For the Ultras, we got a Wind Witch Ice Spell, a Spygale Misty, a Dark Contract with the Entities, and a Crystron Quarion Gandrax. And for the Secrets, we got Brave Eyes, a Pendulum Dragon with absolutely phenomenal artwork on here and a really nice effect, and a Sea Monster of Theseus, the most powerful monster in the game. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any comments or suggestions that you would like to make, feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Head over to the Cool Kingdom website in the description to pick up your own boxes of Raging Tempest today.